adaptation from what we would normally do. Normally our jig is about a rather angry washerwoman. We tried to make this one a little more fun. So here we are, Irish jig. Dance we call the sword dance for obvious reasons. sword dance was originally done by soldiers the night before a battle, and they would do this dance as a prediction of the outcome of the battle. If they kicked their sword, they would die the next day in the battle, and if they did not, they'd be successful. Nowadays, when we compete in the sword dance, if you kick it, you are disqualified in competition. So it's sort of like the same thing. Thank you, everybody. And the good news is, we're not going to battle tomorrow. So, all is well. And next up, we have Emily, and she is going to perform a choreographed dance. And I don't know what it's, does it have a name? No, it's just a really awesome dance. So Emily is going to perform this for you now. Dance with you this evening. It is one of the oldest and most well-known of the Highland dances. It's called the Highland Fling. This dance was done the night before a battle. It was done after a battle on top of the shield of their fallen foe. And this shield had like a big spike in the middle of it. And that would really hurt if you moved around and got it in your foot. So this dance is done on the spot. And we will share our victory dance with you once more. Watching our Cincinnati Highland Dancers perform, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your evening. Make sure you stick around for our 9:30 show over at the main stage in between Seven Nation sets, and we thank you again. Take a bow, dancers.
I wonder how many of these groups are